She's baked in Alaskan, so baked in Alaskan.
Hey everyone, and welcome to the Baked Alaskan. How are you doing today? Well, I'm here. That's about as much as I can say about anything. I'm freezing my ass off, if you couldn't tell. And I thought I'd make a video. Because, hey, you look ridiculous. Why don't you make a video? Anyways, it's Thankful Thursday. And if you're new to my channel, I like to do a video on Thursdays about gratitude and the things in my life that I'm grateful for this week. And I find when I do a weekly kind of recap, I appreciate more things. And that is to say, I remember to appreciate things. Because it's easy to get caught up in the trap of remembering only the bad things that have happened during the week. And, oh, it's been such a bad week. X, Y, and Z happened. All the while forgetting about the nice person that held the door for you when you had your arms full of groceries, or the person who let you in traffic, or, you know, just little things that make your life easier, that are kind, and, you know, that you can pay forward and redirect that energy outward and help other people as well. It really raises your frequency, I think. And it's something that I haven't been doing lately. It's something that I really admittedly need to be doing, because I've been in a really, really bad headspace. I've had some shitty stuff happen in the past month. We didn't really celebrate Christmas per se. Not in the traditional sense. And that was okay. But I think it all kind of contributed to me feeling other this Christmas. So, yeah. That said, this is Thankful Thursday, and I want to encourage everybody to participate on your own time or in your own way. It's a great way to, like I said, raise your frequency, remember what's important, remember the little things that make life better. And, you know, it can be like the smell of fresh cut grass. I would love to smell that right now. It's a blizzard outside, you know? but I always use that example. I love the snow. I just don't love the cold that comes with it, and the fact that I can't get into a car and be warm. I have to. The snow brings challenges for me, you know? And in my own way, I'm grateful for those challenges, because they keep me active. But if I weren't to sit here and think about what was good about it, I'd be like, snow, another snow day. Guess I'm going to stay inside again, because I have really bad balance and I fall down when I go out and it's slippery. But no, that's not what I think. I think I'm going to overcome this. I bought spikes for my shoes. I'm not going to fall down in the wintertime anymore. You know, and it's just a positive attitude. It's just determination, I guess, on my part to not be trapped anymore. And that brings me to my next point, which is I'm grateful for the bariatric program. As much as I dislike some of the things they preach, I understand why they're necessary, because a lot of people don't have the sense of what goes into their bodies and how it affects them, and I do. I had my nutritionist appointment this week, and dietitian appointment, whatever you want to call it. where we went over my food records for the new year, and basically she was like, yeah, you know, you've really got this. And I'm like, yeah, I do. You know, I took nutrition classes in culinary school. I was a chef for 15 years. I have a lot of background knowledge about food. So I know how the consequences of it, and I know how it affects my body. That said, I'm super grateful that I lost 5 pounds over the holidays. Imagine that. Not celebrating kind of pays off. I only went to one holiday dinner, one holiday get-together, and I didn't overeat it either. And I feel great about that. Not that I really overeat at Christmas or anything, but it's hard to be around snacks and sweets and stuff that you don't normally eat, and you don't really realize how that impacts you. So I didn't eat a lot of sweets this year. And the ones that I did really didn't taste good. So that was awesome. These are things going forward that I can reflect back on and think, well, you know, is that cupcake really as good as it looks? Taste as good as it looks, rather. You know, like, is it worth the calories? I always go back to that. My aunt, who is funny as shit, said to me once, or said in my presence once, as she was eating something, ugh, that's not even worth the calories. And she threw it in the trash. And I think there's a lot to learn from that. I mean, for me. Because I find when I spend my money on food or whatever, that I'm like, well, I bought it, I should eat it. You know, it's a waste to throw it away. Even if I don't enjoy it. So I've kind of taken that strategy from her, and I'm grateful for that strategy, because like, I do, you know, obviously have my own issues, but they are different from everyone else's. And let's see, what else am I grateful for? I'm grateful for my friends, particularly my online friends, because I had a really rough week with realizing how alone I am with real life friends here. And you guys are real life friends. I don't want to say that you're not. I just mean, like, I can't physically touch you, so you seem like, you know, ethereal, far away. And but those friends, him in particular, really understand and are kind and let me vent, and I really appreciate you, so thank you. I really needed that this week, and I appreciate that you let me vent to you about things that were going on in my life. I'm grateful to the people that have read the stuff that I write and leave me nice comments of encouragement to continue writing. I admit that I'm not fully aware of my own talent, and I don't have the confidence in myself a lot of times to see shit through because of it. I've got a book 3/4 of the way done. I just need to buckle down and write it, finish writing it, you know? But it just gets scary for me. And about when you have people encouraging you for your writing in other arenas, it makes you realize what you could accomplish if you just finish the book, you know, become a published author, write another book, you know, instead of just writing short stories that people appreciate but don't pay for. I'm all over the map today, guys. This is what you get when you don't see me for weeks at a time. It's like zoom, 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 zoom. So, I'm really grateful for the new subscribers. I'm sure after you see this video, you'll probably unsubscribe, but that's cool too. You gotta do what you gotta do. You gotta go where you wanna go. I get that. But not everything on my channel is the same, and not for everybody, I guess. So, a lot of people take some and leave others, and or watch everything. Just depends on what you like. So, don't base my channel on this video, I guess is what I'm saying. But I have some other videos coming up. I just haven't edited them. I haven't had the time. I've had a lot of doctor's appointments, and but I'm in good health. Don't worry about that. I'm looking after myself. It's just been a lot of doctor's appointments. For which I say thank you, thank you, thank you, Canadian socialized healthcare. Thank you. My gratitude from the bottom of my heart is to Canada for taking care of me in my sickness and in my health. And, yeah. I think I'll leave it on that. That was a good note. And I've talked for like 12 minutes. I never make 12-minute Thankful Thursdays, everybody. It's kind of all over the map today, so thanks for bearing with me if you did. I'd really like to hear from you. I'm going to try to catch up on comments today after I edit these videos and put them up. I appreciate you bearing with my busy schedule and being patient and waiting for replies and understanding that life is not always what you see on YouTube. There's a lot going on behind the scenes, and it can be challenging. So, that said, thank you. Thank you, thank you, subscribers. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for liking. Thank you for commenting and sharing your thankfulness or your Thankful Thursday list or an experience. Thank you. So, that's it. I'm gonna bid you adieu, and I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your week. Got like 2 days to get through, and then you're just sailing into that weekend. I know some of you have to work on the weekend, and that sucks too, but make it good. Remember the good parts and then write them down for your Thankful Thursday. All right, everybody. Take care of yourselves out there and be well.